We are so guilty of this, and you can change your habits. You are going to be able to create a very, very happy, clutter-free home. Stick around to find out the 10 biggest decluttering mistakes that I see people making all the time. Hi fam, and welcome back. My name is Marissa, and I am a minimalist mom, and here at my channel, I like sharing practical ideas on how you and your family can live happier together with less stuff, less stress, hopefully more money, and a lot more fun. So if any of that sounds good to you, please go down and hit the subscribe button to subscribe to my channel and join our family. So today we are going to be talking about the 10 biggest decluttering mistakes. I know I've made them. I'm sure that you've made some too. And these are the big decluttering mistakes to avoid so that you can have your most successful decluttering experience. So we're gonna talk today about not only the biggest decluttering mistakes that people make, but also how to navigate around them. The first decluttering mistake I want to talk to you about today is starting with expectations that are unrealistic. I recently shared an extreme toy decluttering video. We went from a huge amount of toys to a very minimal and manageable amount of toys in the after shot. When I shared this video, of course, a lot of people were amazed by how far we'd come, but that took 5 years and multiple decluttering sessions for us to accomplish. So what I'm trying to say is that when you see these before and after videos and pictures on Instagram or on YouTube or on blogs or wherever you're getting your decluttering advice, keep in mind, a lot of times you're just getting a really quick, cool snippet. And in real life, it's a lot harder and a lot slower to get the same progress. We have been on our minimalism journey for 5 years because I was honestly a sentimental hoarder, and it took a long time for us to get to the level where we are at right now. Don't think that you're going to go from a hoarder to a minimalist in 24 hours. That's not realistic. There's a lot of factors that go into how quickly you can declutter, including the size of your home, the size of your family. Have you decluttered before? Is this your first time decluttering? So go into the experience with an open mind and set realistic expectations for yourself to keep a healthy mindset. Okay, the number two decluttering mistake that I hear people making often is focusing too much on quantity and not focusing on quality. We are looking for quality decluttering. We are not going to focus on a number. If you've been on YouTube, you might have seen some decluttering videos that say, I only own 5 items of clothing, or I travel the world with 47 items that I carry in a backpack. Those videos tend to get a lot of views and they go viral because they are sensational. They really capture the mind and capture the attention. I guarantee that those people didn't declutter and say, hey, I only want to own 47 items. If they ended up with 47 items, that's great. But you should not start out with a number in mind. Instead, focus on the process. Concentrate on keeping those items that add value to your life or that make you happy, and then worry about getting rid of all the rest. And you might end up with 50 items or 500 items or 5,000 items. I've never actually counted how many items I've owned. I'm gonna guess it's more than 500. But who the heck knows? Which brings me to decluttering mistake number three. Watching others declutter and watching inspirational videos on decluttering and minimalism is a wonderful place to start. Don't follow someone else's guidelines word for word and think that that is the only way to declutter. Decluttering is very, very personal. Go with your gut. If something doesn't feel right, don't do it. If you love your books, keep your books. Drop me a comment below and tell me something you would never, ever, ever declutter, no matter what anyone else says. Always stay true to you. Tacky is okay. Color is okay. Collectibles are okay, as long as those are things that bring value to your life or make you happy. Decluttering mistake number four is not having a plan or a vision as to where your decluttering is leading you. Just decluttering for the sake of decluttering is pretty meaningless when you think about it. Why are you decluttering in the first place? Do you want to have more time to play with your kids because you're not straightening up their toys all the time? Do you want to have more fun in your kitchen cooking and you don't have to worry about pulling out your pans and stuff falling out of the cabinets because it's just a mess? What is your idea as to what you're trying to achieve? Visualize where you want to be. You can articulate your goals, talk about them with your husband or your wife. You can journal about it if you're someone who likes to write things down. One of my favorite things to do is just to create a Pinterest board online. You can scroll through and create ideas on how your ideal space would look. Once you have an idea of what you're trying to achieve with your home as far as decluttering, then maybe you can use a checklist and tackle it strategically, going room by room. Checklists are a great way to get started decluttering. In fact, I have a 5-page checklist that you can get for free. I will put the link down in the description below. Certain items I attacked by category and certain items I attacked by room. For me, that was the most efficient way to get rid of a lot of stuff in a very short amount of time. Decluttering mistake number 5 is trying to do either too much or too little at one time. It turns out that decluttering your home is a lot like riding a bicycle. There's a balance to things. If you go too fast, you're gonna get overwhelmed with the huge mess of everything that you've pulled out and lose momentum. If you do too little at once, like trying to only declutter one item each day, you're never going to see results. At the end of the year, you really haven't done that much. That's why going back to having a plan, when you tackle by category or by room and have a manageable amount, and then at the end of the day, everything is put away and looking great, then you're able to get that positive reinforcement that you need to keep up your decluttering momentum. Decluttering mistake number 6 is starting with the hardest stuff first. You don't want to start with your most sentimental items as the first thing that you're going to declutter. That's a recipe for failure. Would you start training for a marathon by running 26 miles right away? No. Decluttering tends to bring up a lot of emotions. If you start with the hardest, most sentimental items first, you're probably not going to know how to deal with the emotions that might arise because of that. You want to set yourself up for decluttering success. Start with things that you know you're excited to get rid of and see how that feels, and then slowly work your way up the mountain from there. Decluttering mistake number 7 is making excuses about why you need to keep an item. You know in your head that you're doing this, and yet you still keep doing it. And I find that a lot of it boils down to guilt. There's financial guilt, where you feel like you've wasted money buying something and it would be a waste to get rid of it. There's environmental guilt, where you feel like you're creating so much waste by getting rid of so much stuff. There's emotional guilt. Maybe this item was a gift. Maybe it's something that was left by a loved one that is no longer with you. Maybe it's something that you loved and loved and loved for so long, but suddenly there's not that spark anymore. But you still feel weird getting rid of something you were so attached to. There's a really wonderful quote by Melva Green, and it goes, "Just because something made you happy in the past doesn't mean you need to keep it forever." And I always try to keep that in mind when I look at things that I might be overly and needlessly sentimentally attached to. Maybe I'm going to lose 10 pounds, so I'm going to be able to wear this dress again next season. Or, oh my gosh, I paid $200 for this. How can I get rid of it? It still has the tags on it. There's always ways to counteract these arguments and offset the excuses and the guilt. Okay, so you say you're gonna lose 10 pounds. How long have you been saying that you're going to lose 10 pounds? Have you been saying it for 5 years? It's a little unrealistic to keep it. Likewise, if you have, say, a pair of shoes that you've never worn and you spent $200 on those, you can sell them online. I have a great video on how to sell your clutter. I was making over $1,000 a month at one point between my kids' nap times. just selling my old clutter online. When you catch yourself making excuses about why you need to keep something, you probably don't need to keep that item. Start flexing that decluttering muscle. Okay, mistake number 8. Oh, mistake number 8. We are so guilty of this. I'm gonna say it's not my fault. It's not my fault. It's my husband's fault. I'm gonna blame him. Is rehoming clutter too slowly? How many times have you put something in your trunk with the intention to donate it, but then you forget about it and you find it later? Or you put it out in the garage with the intention, huge fly. Or you put it out in the garage with the intention of getting rid of it, but then your kids see it and they're like, mommy, mommy, I want that toy. Bring it back, mom. And you have to bring it back into your house. One time I had a huge pile of things to donate in the back of our truck, and my husband was taking the kids out and he opened the trunk and they saw the toys. It was just a shark feeding frenzy of grabbing out all of these toys that I honestly wanted to get rid of. And I just looked at my husband like,
are you serious right now?
So my point is, when you are intending on getting rid of something, have a system that you're going to get it out of the house, out of sight, out of mind, and send it to its new home as quickly as possible. If you're selling things, it's gonna take a little bit more time. That's why in the video that I mentioned earlier, I recommend having opaque, non-see-through plastic bins to store it, or immediately put it in the trunk of the car and take it to Goodwill. Get that clutter out fast. All right, so mistake number 9. Now you're done with decluttering, you need to find a home for every specific item. So you always know where that item is going back to. If an item doesn't have a home, it tends to just kind of float around and become like clutter. When you're done decluttering, designate a home for every specific item, and that item will just go right back to its home every time. And the great thing about this is every member of the family knows where that item belongs, and that means that the husband will be able to put away the measuring cups in the right place, the kids will know which toys go where, and it makes it much easier for you to clean up because other people can help you. You're not the only one that's figuring out where things go. All right, finally, we are at decluttering mistake number 10. One of the biggest decluttering mistakes someone can make is not changing the habits that led to them acquiring so much clutter in the first place. Are you a shopaholic that's constantly buying new clothes? When you're shopping, start asking yourself, do I really need this? What items does this clothing piece fit with in my current wardrobe? Do I have space for this? If you're someone who has a lot of paper clutter that tends to build up in your office and you go out to the mailbox, maybe you need to start sorting those items right away when you come in and separate them. Stuff that needs attention and stuff that needs to be shredded. Look inside yourself and say, what habits do I have that have contributed to me becoming a cluttered person? When you can objectively put yourself under the microscope and say, this is what I am doing and I'm going to change this, then you have come a long, long way. If you know in advance about these decluttering mistakes and you can change your habits, I am confident that you are going to be able to create a very, very happy, clutter-free home. So I am so happy that you sat with me today and we were able to talk about the biggest decluttering mistakes that people make. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give it a like and consider going in down and subscribing to my channel and joining our family. I would love to see you around again. Take care. Bye.